morning, everyone. Right now, we're going to ask all the children to please come forward. And let's give them a hand. I want to ask you a question, and I want to also say something. Do you know that your body is the temple of the Lord, and you're supposed to keep it clean and holy at all given times? You got to do a sweep job every now and then. Go in and sweep and dust and all of that with the Word of God. You know, being obedient is one of the things that He loves the most. And let Him know how much you love Him. It's another thing. And every now and then, sometimes, we get these things in our head telling us, well, I don't like so-and-so because so-and-so is this, that, and other. That's when you got to stand up and fight that battle and praise God and say, God, I don't want the thoughts in my head no more, Lord. Let me love the way you show me how to love, the way you have given us the fruits, Lord. These fruits, not apples and oranges, but the fruits of the Spirit. They're the ones that we're supposed to go by. You know, I remember when I was 9 years old and these kids chased me home. I went home to my mother and father and I cried and I told them that I'm being chased. And my mother said, you know who you are. I'm thinking I'm small, you know. But no, my mother said, you are a child of God. Go out and fight. Not this fight, but with the Word. So I looked at them at 9 years old. Do you understand, Mom? I ran home with my feet. I didn't catch the bus home. I had to run home. I didn't think they understood. But my mother kept telling me over and over, you know who you are. You are a child of God. Mom, what she was doing, she was speaking the words into the atmosphere. That's the words that we need to hear. The words that take hold. And those words give us understanding of positive meaning of God. Knowing who He is. Knowing who you are with God. It makes you stand tall. It'll fight all your battles. Because later on, somewhere down the line, when the kids that used to chase me home used to move aside, you know, because of those words, they moved aside. You know how the Red Sea was parting? That's how they moved aside. They were scared. You know what they said to me? They wouldn't bother me no more. They said, you know what? I don't want to have nothing to do with her. Because she keeps saying them God things. Well, them God things brought me victory. You know, it stopped them kids from chasing me home. It stopped people from bothering me because they was God words. And I used them. And they was necessary to be used no matter what you're going through. Use them God words and watch you get over. Sweep that house out. You know, because it needs dusting. Like I said, it needs dusting every now and then. This temple, it must be clean. It must be clean. When them thoughts come up against you, no, 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 don't accept them because you know what? They're going to park and take place. Don't give them a vote. You're not voting. Get out. I don't want you. No more. I don't want nothing to do with you. Now let us pray in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you for the children that you have given us, O Lord. We ask, Lord, no matter what they're going through, Father God, that you give them the courage and the knowledge and the wisdom to stand up to it. Not run, Lord, but to stand up to it, Lord. The battle like David did collide, Lord. He cut his head off. That's what we got to do, Lord. Cut it off at the root, Lord. Don't let it grow no more. Don't let it pass this in our body or our minds, Father God. Lord, we just thank you. We give you the praise. We ask that you be with you and these children coming and they're going, Father God. That you would camp your angels around them, Father God. Covering them with the blood of Jesus, Father God. That blood is not its strength or its power, Father God. Touch them, Lord. Not just them, but those of them that is attached to them, Father God. Touch them, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Touch them right now, Father God. Build them up, Lord. Don't let them be a coward to your word, but stand up and use it, Father God. In the name of Jesus. Amen.